إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدئ الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي الله سبحانه وتعالى from his great favors upon mankind is that he bless whomsoever he wish with children. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in the Quran that even the prophets and the messengers, they seek this bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلًا مِّن قَبْلِكَ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ أَزْوَاجًا وَذُرِّيَّةً That we have indeed sent messengers before you. And we have made for them wives and children and progeny. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many places of the Quran, He mentioned the dua of many prophets and messengers asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for children. As it is well known, the dua of Ibrahim, Rabbi habli min as-salihin, O my Lord, bless me from amongst the righteous, meaning from amongst the righteous children. Bless me with righteous children. And Zachariah, إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْنِي فَرْدًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ Zachariah, he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless him with children. And this is from amongst the greatest bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and from among the things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he encourages ummah as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told his companions and this ummah that he will boast with our numbers on the day of judgment. So we should strive to have as much children as we can. And we find, unfortunately, today many people, they are abstaining and deliberately trying not to have children. Many people today, they are running from having children, not knowing this bounty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon them. not knowing the struggle of those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed that they do not have children. Many people, they are trying their best to conceive. They are trying their best going to this doctor and that doctor to see what is their problem. Why is it that they are not conceiving? And you have on the other hands those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed with this virtue, but yet they run away from it for one reason or the other. You have many people because they are so attached and they forget the hereafter. They are so attached to this dunya and the enjoyment of this dunya that they see their children and having children to be a barrier for them. That children, if they have children, they will not be able to go to parties. They will not be able to enjoy themselves. They will not be able to go on road trips and so on. Forgetting that this dunya is temporary. Forgetting that they will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sooner or later. Forgetting that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned that from amongst the deeds that do not cut off after a person passed away is their children. That righteous child making dua for you. From amongst the deeds the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has he mentioned, when we are buried in our grave, in qata'a amaluna illa min thalath, our deeds cut off except from three doors and three ways. And from among them is that righteous son making dua for you, that righteous daughter making dua for you. And there is no one that is going to make dua for you after you die more than that righteous child. Everyone else, they are going to forget about you. Most of the time, no matter how much good you do to them, they are going to forget about you. And when they do make dua, it's going to be for themselves and their own children and their own parents. But if you have a righteous son or a righteous daughter, they are going to remember you and make dua for you. And that is going to be from amongst the greatest benefit that you will have in the hereafter. And just to note, this is not to point fingers at anyone. And this is not to judge anyone. And we should not judge anyone if we see that they do not have children or they do not have a lot of children. You should not even go and ask them why. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned in the Quran, وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ عَقِيمًا, he make among those whom he wills عَقِيمًا, barren, that they do not have children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he decreed that for some people, when no matter how much they try, they will not have any children because Allah has decreed that for them. And many people, they are going through medical complication and so on, that is preventing them from having children. And then you go and you say something to them, you do not know the stress that you may put them in. So just to know, this is not to judge anyone, but this is to address if we have that mentality running away from children and having children, if we think that that is going to be a means of our stress in this world, rather is the total opposite. Yes, we have to be patient with them. Yes, there is struggle with them, but the outcome is much more bigger and greater for us to forsake this great bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. After giving that introduction, reminding ourselves about the virtue of having children, I would like to remind myself firstly, and everyone, especially those who have children, about the great importance of looking after those children and paying heed to their tarbiyah and their well-being. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. O you who believe, save yourself and your family from a fire. وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ Whose flame, whose fuel is men and stone. عَلَيْهَا مَلَائِكَةٌ غِلَاظٌ شِدَادٌ لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ In charge of this fire are angels, stern and strict. لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم. They will not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding that which they are commanding with. And what are they commanding with except to punish the inhabitants of the fire of hell? So we have an obligation upon ourselves to teach and to train our children to the best of our ability. And from among those obligations that we have with our children, as they are many, as they are too many for us to deal with in one khutbah, but from among those obligations is our obligation to be just between our children. As Nu'man ibn Bashir radiallahu anhu, he said that his father wanted to give him a gift, and his mother told his father to hold the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as a witness when you give him this gift. To let the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam testify to what you are doing. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he asked him, Do you have other children? He said, Yes. He said, Have you given them the same? He said, No. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, I'm not going to testify upon injustice. In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he asked him, Do you want all your children to obey you the same way? And he said, Yes. He said, So give them the same way. Be just in your giving. And from the wisdom of being just between your children is so that you do not cause envy and enmity between them. Yaqub alayhi salam, when Yusuf alayhi salam narrated to him his dream, when he saw 11 stars and the sun and the moon prostrating to him, Yaqub alayhi salam, he said to Yusuf, Ya bunayya la taqusus ru'yaka ala ikhwatika fayakiduna laka kayda inna ash-shaytana lil insani aduwwun mubin. He said, Oh my son, do not narrate your dream to your brothers so that they may plot against you. Indeed, shaitan is a clear enemy to mankind. We see that Yaqub alayhi salam, even though he loved Yusuf the most amongst his children, and love is something which is in our heart and we do not have any control over it. It is from the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has pardoned us of if we love one of our children more than the other. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said when he gives each one of them something, he said that this is what I control. Oh Allah, do not take me to account for that which I do not control. Meaning the things of his heart, from among those things is loving one more than the other, something that someone do not have any ability to control. And Yaqub alayhi salam, even though he loved Yusuf more than all the other children, he told him, do not narrate your dream to your brother. He did not strive to show the brothers that Yusuf is better than them. He did not strive to show the brothers the virtue of Yusuf, because that is going to cause enmity and hatred more between them. And similarly, we should not do that which will cause enmity between our children. Many times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will favor one of our children over the other with a gift, with a talent, with something, whether it is with their manners, their behavior, whether it is with their skill, their accomplishment in school. We should not compare them to each other. We should not tell the next one he needs to be like the other one and make those comparisons and show the virtue between them. Because that is well known to be from amongst the greatest thing that caused enmity between the children. And he said to Yusuf, Inna shaytana lil insani aduhum mubin. Indeed, shaytan is a clear enemy for mankind. And this is something we need to keep at the tip of our mind when we are dealing with ourselves and our children. Know that the shaitan is there trying his best to cause mischief between us and between our children. Know that the shaitan is not going to leave any door open except that he enters it trying to cause our children to go astray. And from this we should be careful of the things that we do with our children. Careful of the opportunities we give them. Many of us, for example, we leave our children at a very young age with these devices, the phone and the laptop and the iPad. We leave it with them in their rooms. And you say that you trust your children, but you forget that the shaitan is going to be there trying his best to cause that child to go astray. And even if you trust them, do not open for them another door of temptation. In this world there is enough trials and tribulation. There is enough that you need to go through in order to hold yourself upon the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you open these doors for your children, you make it more difficult for them to be upright. But if you close these doors, they will not be tested from them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us steadfast and to keep our children steadfast. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from the plot of the shaytan. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك هذا وأقيم الصلاة.